something. After he finished, he felt bad about not being with the peace and tranquility that his grandmother gave him. Made to love and went to sleep and stayed like that for a while. He suddenly awoke to frantic noises and panicky voices. He looked up and he was in a different place. He saw people running everywhere with fear and apprehension in their eyes. Fear settled as he realized where it was. It was the day of judgment. A million thoughts rushed through his head. How could this be? It seemed so far away. I thought I had so much time. Then his heart began to race as he too waited for his questioning. The crowd of people suddenly split into two and he was dragged into the center. He saw his whole life in front of him like a movie. Then he awaited for the scale to determine his destination. The angel called his name. He was to be sent to hell. His heart dropped. He began yelling out all his good deeds. How could this be? I fasted the month of Ramadan. I prayed. I helped others. And I did what Allah commanded me to. But the two angels picked him up and dragged him to hell. He was helpless. His last pleas were, had not the holy prophet of Allah said, how clean would a person be who bathes in a river 5 times a day? So too does the soul perform 5 times, cleanse someone of their sins. He began yelling, my prayers, my prayers, my prayers. But the two angels did not stop and they threw him into Jahannam. After he fell 5 or 6 feet, a hand reached out and grabbed him and pulled him back to the top. He looked up and saw a man. He asked him, who are you? The man replied by saying, I am your prayers. The boy said, what took you so long? You rescued me at the very last minute. And the man said, did you not forget? You also prayed me at the last minute. The boy suddenly woke up and he was back in his house. He heard the adhan for Salat and he quickly got up to go pray. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Aysha Khan and my topic is about prayer. Prayer. One of the 5 pillars of Islam. The first thing we're going to be asked about once we die. Something so vital that it can take us to heaven or do us to hell. Yet sadly, people don't grasp their words. Did you know that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam pressed the importance of Salat at his deathbed? And it's mentioned in the Quran several times. In Surah Al-Muddathir, Ayahs 42 to 43, God says, what led you to the hellfire? They will say, we were not opposed to prayer. In Surah Ma'un, Ayahs 46, God says, so woe to the worshippers who are neglectful of their prayers, those who want but to be seen of men. Most people, however, shrug off their prayers and make empty promises to make it up later. Some think it'll fit into their precious time, and others pray hastily and belittle their salah. All these excuses are not accepted in the sight of Allah. Instead of seeing these prayers as a burden, we should accept them as a true blessing that they are. By praying, we get to have a deep spiritual connection with our God, and it's what differentiates us from other religions. Did you know the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the only difference between a believer and a non-believer is salah. Not to mention the fact that by praying we get to have our sins be taken away. Once Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam shook a dry branch of a tree so that all of the leaves of the branch fell off. Then the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the sins of those who pray Salah drop off as the leaves of this branch fell off. Did you know that there are even health benefits of praying? When you're standing, blood is being pumped to your head. However, the amount of blood being pumped to your head is not sufficient amount. But when you're prostrating, or when you're in sujood, the amount of blood being pumped to your head is increased to a sufficient amount. Also, when you're prostrating, your sinuses and bronchial get strained, which results in a less chance of catching sinusitis and bronchitis. And finally, when you're breathing, 2/3 of your lungs are being used. But when you're prostrating, the last 1/3 of your lungs are being used, which results in a less chance of catching lung disease. SubhanAllah, this only further goes to show the wisdom behind our magnificent Creator. Even the act of wudu has countless benefits. Abu Huraira reported, Allah's Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, when a bondsman, a Muslim or believer, washes his face with wudu, every sin they contemplated will be washed away with his face, along with the water, over the last drop of water. When he washes his hands, every sin they wrought will be effaced from his hands with the water, over the last drop of water. And when he washes his feet, every sin toward which his feet have walked toward will be washed away with the water, over the last drop of water. With the result that he comes out pure of sins. Once again, God gives us more incentive to pray. Still not convinced? Do you know that a person who makes wudu cleanses their nose from germs, dust, and other connected things? And a person who doesn't make wudu is more liable to catch nearly 11 different kinds of germs. So in conclusion, prayer has many benefits in this life and the hereafter. Our healthy benefit, our healthy body, and the immeasurable bounties of paradise, not enough to keep it in mind. Think about this for a second. Would you rather make wudu with a nice, cold, refreshing water in your bathroom sink, or with boiling, burning hot water? Would you rather pray on a soft rug in the comfort of your house or on scorching hot spiky flames? This is what awaits you, but when you don't pray. Ask yourself, is it worth it? 5 minutes a day, 5 times a day. That's all it takes. About the time it takes to